Well, good morning. We are so excited to celebrate as one body today. Two churches coming together to celebrate one Savior. We would love it, even if this song is not familiar with you, if you would stand up and sing with us so we can proclaim together in one voice, we are not ashamed of Jesus Christ. Welcome to worship. You can have a seat if you'd like.
You may sit down if you want to. You can remain standing as you please. Estamos muy contentos de estar hoy acá en la casa del Señor. Y me gustaría, no sé cómo usted acostumbre, pero si le veo las caras a los presentes, a mí siempre me gusta pasar lista a ver las ovejas que vinieron, las que me faltan, para estar al tanto de ellos. Pero bueno, en medio de la oscuridad trataré de verle, pero le damos la bienvenida a todos, a los que acostumbran a venir, a los que hace algún tiempo no han venido a causa de la pandemia y de otros males, pero qué bueno que podemos estar en la casa del Señor. We are really very glad to have you all here, and we can share together despite pandemics and some other evils, right? So welcome to the house of the Lord. And if there is any pastor here in this room that I don't know, and if you're here, I don't know, Pastor, raise your hand if there is any pastor. I know the pastors are sitting over here, but if there is any pastor that I do not know, you can come front and join us to this side, because we are celebrating the Pastor's Appreciation Month, right? And we were supposed to celebrate the anniversary of our church, IBL, Iglesia Bautista de Leyland, but the founding person, the one who started the church in her house, is hospitalized, so I ask you to pray for her. Her name is Betty, but we have decided to have two celebrations then together, the appreciation, Pastor's Appreciation Month, and then the IBL anniversary next month, perhaps, God willing. Así que estaremos celebrando el aniversario de la iglesia la semana, el mes próximo, y este mes estamos celebrando el tiempo, el mes de agradecimiento pastoral por la labor que los siervos del Señor hacen para guiar la grey conforme a la voluntad de Dios. Yo tengo muchas cosas que decirle, pero no voy a llevarme todo el tiempo. Me gustaría que nos saludáramos todos. Dígale que está al lado suyo. Say hello to the one close to you. Bless the one close to you. Say hello. God bless you. We are so glad to be here today in the Lord's house, praising together, worshiping together, right? Y entonces, hermanos míos, que estamos acá, le voy a dar una oportunidad a John. I'm going to give him an opportunity because I don't want him to cry, right? So he's got a lot of things just to communicate, so I'm just giving him an opportunity, so pay close attention to what he's going to say. He's going to say in Spanish this morning.
That's right. Well, sadly, I do not speak Spanish, so if somebody's next to somebody that they don't speak both, then if you can translate for them, I'd appreciate it. In time, hopefully, you guys can teach me enough Spanish to where I'll be able to say something other than maybe baloney or something like that. And so we are so glad each of you are here. Those at home that are watching through technology, as far as our online audience, you have not switched channels. You are not on a Spanish channel, okay? And so you have picked the right place. This could be a great joint service. And I was looking at the brochure that you guys produced, and, you know, I really feel like that it was probably blessed by the Lord. It says, IBL and Revive, two churches working together as one family in the name of Jesus under the guidance of the Holy Spirit for the only glory of God the Father. And you know, we've really, I have to tell you, the pastor, Pastor Jason first mentioned the possibility of IBL coming and sharing our space here and working together as a sister church here at this ministry, you know, naturally all of us are wondering whether that could work out, things like that. He was so enthusiastic about it, and I really feel like right from the beginning it's been something, though, that the Holy Spirit has really worked. And immediately when we met, felt total comfort about it, and it's been a great thing. So we appreciate IBL, and of course, we love our church family as far as Revive, too, and we're all part of the big kingdom of God anyway, so it's good that we can all be together and gather together. And those at home, we're glad you're at home there, and you can join in. I want you speaking Spanish. I want you singing in Spanish. I want you singing in English. Clap your hands and have a good time. We'll have a good time together. I've got three announcements that I wanted to make today. And if I can get my phone open here. Three announcements. So the first one is for our preschool here at Revive. The preschool is having a fall festival for the kids on October 30th, 10 o'clock in the morning till 11 o'clock. They can use some workers. Okay, that's from 10 to 11. Allison is the director of the preschool. Not sure if she's here today or not, if she was able to make it, but she'll be here, or some of our ladies, and they'll be here. If you can volunteer for that hour, and in fact, we'd like to stretch it one more hour after that, because we've got Miss Julie in our school. Julie, right, wave your hand back there. All right, so Julie's having field day right after that, and it's really just a fall festival time for each of the groups of kids. So for the preschool and for the elementary and middle school, and you'll be passing out candy and all. And if you can bring some extra candy for that, that'd be great. All right, and that's going to be October 30th from 10 to about 12 o'clock, actually. Then this is one for IBL and for Revive, for everybody, because just about everybody can work in one fashion or another. So Eddie, where's Eddie at? There's Eddie back there. All right, Eddie is the slave driver as far as work days here at the church. We're going to have a work day at the church November 14th, starting at 8 o'clock. IBL or Revive members, if you guys can make it for that, that'd be great. And the last one, the one that's coming up very, very quick, That is for our fall festival, which will be Wednesday night. Wednesday night in IBL, we're hoping you'll join in. We need more cars for the trunk or treat. We need more workers. We definitely need a lot of candy. And, you know, in the past, we've had hundreds and hundreds of people show up to this. Now, this one is a mini one because of the COVID. But if you can come, it starts at 6 o'clock on Wednesday night. You need to be here earlier than that. And so if you can be here for setup, you know, 4 o'clock or so, that'd be great. So it'd be Wednesday the 28th. And if you can be here around 4 o'clock, come. You'll have a good time. Even if you're working, handing out candy, it'll be a great time. And it'll be till about 8 o'clock, then we'll do some cleanup. Now, what we feature at that is trunk or treat, where we line up the cars, and the kids in their masks and all come along, and they play games in the back of the trunks, they get candy, they have a good time. Then we also have in the building, in our fellowship hall, we will convert that into a version, what we call a glimpse of heaven and hell. So as kids and adults walk through, they'll get just a make-believe glimpse of what hell will be like, and then we take them to an area, a glimpse of what heaven would be like. Then when they go out these doors, we will have individuals there that will be prepared to share the gospel in English and Spanish. Okay? So invite your friends, invite your neighbors, invite folks to this. When is it?
Wednesday.
What time? And you're going to be workers, so you're going to be here at what time? Excellent, all right? Dress comfortably. It is quite a bit of work, but, you know, passing out candy and things like that, you know, grab you a couple pieces of candy yourself. It'll be a good time. And now the next part of the fall festival, and this is one that our members really like, and we want IBL because we hear some of you folks can cook a little bit. Okay. Cook-off, all right? Now, Eddie, I mentioned Eddie as far as on our work day. Now, Eddie won the chili cook-off last year, okay? Make sure we translate this right. We were a little skeptical because his chili looked like Wendy's chili, okay? Now, he's assured me this year he's not bringing Wendy's chili to win it, but he may be bringing Steak and Shake chili, so we don't want him to win it with that, right? But Eddie will probably be in the competition. He'll be fixing his up. You guys can fix up a chili. Bring it sometime. We're changing it, not on Tuesday. Bring it that day, just sometime during the day, Wednesday. Plug it in the kitchen. Make sure your name's on it. Have it here by at least 5 o'clock, all right? And sometime during the evening there, if it's after, if we've got lots of people, if it's afterwards, we'll have some chili afterwards. We'll judge it, and then we'll end up giving a nice trophy out, and then we've got the church trophy that stays here. But we'll have a trophy for you as far as the winner and first and second place. So if you're a good cook and you want to fix some chili up, do that, and we'll enjoy it. The workers get to share that, and we'll get to eat that up, and it'll be a great thing. So any questions about the fall festival? Eddie, any questions? Okay, I like to pick on Eddie just a little bit. Well, we're glad you guys are here. We're going to get on with the program. Thank you for all that you're doing for us and with us, and we're going to have a great day today. Thank you, Pastor.
Thank you. Yo voy a resumir lo que él dijo a la Iglesia Bautista de Leyland. Pórtense bien, contribuyan con todo y enséñanos español porque es el idioma del cielo. Now I'm going to translate that into English. I'm going to summarize what he said. IBL, behave properly. Cooperate with everything and teach them Spanish because there is a language of heaven. Okay, now we're going to read the Bible. I'm going to invite Leo and Coke to sit over here because they are going to work with the translation. All that, please, come to this side. Les invito ahora a leer la palabra de Dios. Porque dentro de todo este entusiasmo que nos da el Espíritu Santo, hemos venido a adorar al que todo se lo merece. Y estamos celebrando un mes de apreciación pastoral. Y precisamente es al buen pastor a quien nosotros debemos honrar. So, we're going to honor the one who deserves honor, glory, and the empire ever and forever, who is our Lord Jesus Christ, the shepherd, the bishop of the souls, and the head of this church. Amen. We are going to read Psalm 145, verses 1 through 3.
Dice así la palabra del Señor.
And so it says the word of the Lord.
Te alabaré, mi Dios, mi Rey, y bendeciré tu nombre eternamente y para siempre.
I will extol you, my God, O King, and I will bless your name forever and ever.
Cada día te bendeciré y alabaré tu nombre eternamente y para siempre.
Every day I will bless you and I will praise your name forever and ever.
Grande es Jehová y digno de suprema alabanza, y su grandeza es inescrutable.
Great is the Lord and greatly to be praised, and his greatness is unsearchable.
So we are going to sing, or we're going to praise together, and there is a one that we have chosen, which is Majesty. We're going to sing in Spanish, right? So you're ready over there, but I'm sure that you know it in English as well, so you can join us, and together we can just work this out. The most important thing is that we praise the Lord together. Amen.
Para alabar al único que es digno de honra. Cantemos majestad al Señor.
Padre Santo, gracias porque estamos en tu casa. adorando tu santo y bendito nombre. Y un día estaremos en tu misma presencia en el reino celestial junto al coro de ángeles, y aquel día será un gran tiempo, Señor, en que tú serás alabado y se lo serás por la eternidad. Gracias porque tú nos ayudas en medio de los problemas de la tecnología, pero el corazón está dispuesto para alabarte en espíritu y en verdad. Recibe todo lo que hagamos aquí hoy, que sea tu espíritu quien nos guíe, y que solo tú recibas la honra, la gloria, porque solo tú eres digno de ella, lo cual pedimos en el nombre de Jesús. Amén. Tenemos ciertas dificultades con el audio, y realmente lo que ensayamos no es lo que salió, pero hay algo importante, y quiero aprovechar esto, y es que hemos tenido mucha dificultad últimamente. We have had a lot of difficulties and setbacks lately. What we have just sung this moment is not what we have prayed. You see the difficulty with the audio and all those things. Pero nosotros continuamos adelante porque somos el pueblo de la victoria. So we go forward because we are the people of victory. So we are not chicken out, right? Neither pandemic, nor politics, nor audio, nor Facebook, Google, or whatever is going to stop the Church of Jesus Christ. Amen? Amen. So we go ahead with this program. Seguimos adelante con este programa. Y corresponde en esta hora, según ustedes tienen ahí, una canción que van a cantar los jóvenes. Estamos tratando, pasen adelante los jóvenes. We are trying to motivate the youth of our church. Our church is very young, right? It's very young, just a few years. And we are trying to motivate the youth because they are going to go ahead just passing the baton, right? Y tenemos que entrenarlo porque cuando los viejos no estemos acá, entonces eso va a ser tremendo. I'm inviting those who sing in Revive so they can join because they know the song as well. I don't know where they are, Jordan and somebody else. I invited them. Hey, hello, where are you? Just step forward, please. Because they are really very nervous. That's their first time, su primera vez que van a alabar a Dios. Pero miren, no importa que estemos saliendo por la televisión o por las redes, que a mí no me gusta eso, pero estamos en familia. Y con la confianza que Dios nos ha dado, with this confidence that God has given to us, we're going to go ahead. So don't pay attention to cameras, and if there is anyone who wants to judge, that's their problem. We are not here to be judged or to judge, but to praise the Lord. Amen? Where do we go?
Stay. everybody to sing with us, okay? Let's praise Jesus. Let's make this our time. Let's not make this the devil's time. Let's make this our praise.
Y te cantamos a ti, nuestro Salvador y Rey.
You see, we have to prepare the new generation. As I was telling you, we've got to pass the baton. There is something Pastor Jason was sharing with us in the leadership retreat we had recently. We have to prepare our youth. The evil is preparing our youth through Google, through Facebook, and we have to prepare the youth to go ahead with this we're doing now, that is just standing the kingdom of our Lord Jesus Christ. Así que seguimos entrenando a la juventud para que sigan adelante, sean el relevo, y extiendan el reino hasta que Cristo venga, and Jesus is coming soon. We are going to read the Bible now.
Los invito a buscar ahí nuestras Biblias para leer la palabra de Dios.
I'm inviting you to look up in your Bibles.
En el libro de la primera de Tesalonicenses, capítulo 5.
In the first epistle of Thessalonians, chapter 5.
Comenzando desde el verso 1 hasta el verso 23.
And we'll read to, from verse 1 through verse 23.
Y dice así la palabra de nuestro Señor.
And so it says.
Pero acerca de los tiempos y de las ocasiones, no tenéis necesidad, hermanos, de que yo os escriba.
But concerning the times and the seasons, brethren, you have no need that I should write to you.
Porque vosotros sabéis perfectamente que el día del Señor vendrá así como ladrón en la noche.
For you yourselves know perfectly that the day of the Lord so comes as a thief in the night.
Que cuando digan paz y seguridad, entonces vendrá sobre ellos destrucción repentina como los dolores a la mujer encinta. Y no escaparán.
For when they say peace and safety, then sudden destruction comes upon them as labor pains upon a pregnant woman, and they shall not escape.
Mas vosotros, hermanos, no estáis en tinieblas para que aquel día os sorprenda como ladrón.
But you, brethren, are not in darkness so that this day should overtake you as a thief.
Porque todos vosotros sois hijos de la luz e hijos del día. No somos de la noche ni de las tinieblas.
You are all sons of light and sons of the way, of the day. We are not of the night nor of the darkness.
Por tanto, no durmamos como los demás, sino velemos y seamos sobrios.
Therefore, let us not sleep as others do, but let us watch and be sober.
Pues los que duermen, de noche duermen, y los que se embriagan de noche se embriagan.
For those who sleep, sleep at night, and those who get drunk are drunk at night.
Pero nosotros que somos del día, seamos sobrios, habiéndonos vestido con la coraza de fe y de amor, y con la esperanza de salvación como yelmo.
But let us who are of the day be sober, putting on the breastplate of faith and love as a helmet, and as a helmet the hope of salvation.
Porque no nos ha puesto Dios para ira, sino para alcanzar salvación por medio de nuestro Señor Jesucristo.
For God did not appoint us to wrath, but to obtain salvation through our Lord Jesus Christ.
Quien murió por nosotros, para que ya sea que velemos o que durmamos, vivamos juntamente con Él.
Who died for us, what, whether we wake or sleep, we should live together with Him.
Por lo cual, animaos unos a otros y edificaos unos a otros, así como lo hacéis.
Therefore, comfort each other and edify one another just as you also are doing.
Os rogamos, hermanos, que reconozcáis a los que trabajan entre vosotros y os presiden en el Señor y os amonestan.
And we urge you, brethren, to recognize those who labor among you and are over you in the Lord and admonish you.
Y que los tengáis en mucha estima y amor por causa de su obra. Tened paz entre vosotros.
And to esteem them very highly in love for their work's sake, be at peace among yourselves.
También os rogamos, hermanos, que amonestéis a los ociosos, que alentéis a los de poco ánimo, que sostengáis a los débiles, que seáis pacientes para con todos.
Now we exhort you, brethren, warn those who are unruly, comfort the faint-hearted, uphold the weak, be patient with all.
Mirad que ninguno pague a otro mal por mal, antes seguid siempre lo bueno unos para con otros, y para con todos.
See that no one renders evil for evil to anyone, but always pursue what is good both for yourselves and for all.
Estad siempre gozosos.
Rejoice always.
Orad sin cesar.
Pray without ceasing.
Dad gracias en todo, porque esta es la voluntad de Dios para con vosotros en Cristo Jesús.
In everything give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you.
No apaguéis el espíritu.
Do not quench the spirit.
No menosprecéis las profecías.
Do not despise prophecies.
Examinadlo todo, retened lo bueno.
Test all things, hold fast what is good.
Absteneos de toda especie de mal.
Abstain from every form of evil.
Y el mismo Dios de paz os santifique por completo, y todo vuestro ser, espíritu, alma y cuerpo sea guardado irreprensible para la venida de nuestro Señor Jesucristo.
Now may the God of peace himself sanctify you completely, and may our whole spirit, soul, and body be preserved blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. And the church says, amen. Amen. May God bless his word in our lives. So we go ahead with this program, and now, according to what I have here in this paper that I just wrote myself, but I'm getting stopped because I'm as nervous as many others are today. I'm sorry about that. We have a special participation of a brother who has prepared something for pastors today. Victor? Let me tell you something. When I was taught in English, that was a long time ago, one of my professors told me, when I was in the States studying in the university, I learned something. I learned that when you buy something, that's what my teacher used to tell me, said my professor to me, we try everything. And the last thing that we do is read instructions. And then I found one of the instructions that read, and it went like this. After you have tried enough, please read the instructions.
Aprendemos a amar a nuestros pastores y que Dios les bendiga abundantemente, porque ellos nos guían en todo. Pastor, reconozco tu labor y tu ejemplo llevo dentro. Dentro de mi corazón, pastor, Dios te bendiga y te guarde, tu ministerio respalde hasta cumplir tu misión, pastor, tu trabajo es sagrado. Por muy pocos estimado, pero hay un galardón. Mi Dios tiene un reino preparado para ti muy reservado, donde irás mi buen pastor. Pastor, cuántas veces has orado por mi pecho atormentado, por una pena o dolor. Pastor, por mí te he visto llorar al predicar un sermón o postrado en el altar. Gracias damos a Dios por nuestros pastores, nuestros guías espirituales y a Jesucristo que nos ayuda. Pastor, reconozco tu labor y tu ejemplo llevo dentro, dentro de mi corazón. Pastor, Dios te bendiga y te guarde, tu ministerio respalde hasta cumplir tu misión. Pastor, tu trabajo es sagrado, por muy pocos estimado, pero hay un galardón. Mi Dios tiene un reino preparado para ti muy reservado, donde irás mi buen pastor. Pastor, cuántas veces has orado por mi pecho atormentado, por una pena o dolor. Pastor, por mí te he visto llorar al predicar un sermón o postrado en el altar. Gloria a Dios. Bendigamos a nuestros pastores y a nuestro Señor. Bendiciones.
Mientras el coro se alista para cantar, porque yo le decía al Pastor Jason que íbamos a improvisar un poco. I was telling Pastor Jason this morning, we're going to improvise a little bit. So I was the one who skipped the script, right? So now we are going to have the choir. But while the choir is just stepping forward and then a line here up front, I'm going to invite Alegría Choice. She's been the wife and the helpmeet of Pastor Francisco for a long time. And I would like you to step forward and pray for all pastors and give the glory to the pastors of Pastor, who is our Lord Jesus Christ.
Father in heaven, what a privilege to come before your throne of grace through our mediator, Jesus Christ. We give you all the praise and the honor and the glory. Dear Jesus, we recognize you are the good shepherd. You are the good pastor, the excellent pastor. We thank you for the servants that you have chosen to be your representatives as shepherds, as pastors of us, the flock. Thank you for these servants of God. Thank you for their wives. Thank you for their children. And we ask your blessing on each one. Give them great joy and satisfaction for the work, the task that you have given to them. We give you all the praise and the honor and the glory. Padre amado, qué privilegio estar ante tu trono de gracia. Te alabamos y te bendecimos porque entramos por medio de Jesús nuestro Señor. Gracias, Jesús, porque tú eres el buen pastor, el excelente pastor. Y tú has levantado siervos para representarte a ti, para servirnos a nosotros, la Grey. Te alabamos y te bendecimos, Jesús, nuestro buen pastor. Gracias, Padre, por tu palabra que dice que el Padre nos agarra por una mano y Jesús nos agarra por la otra mano. ¿Quién nos podrá arrebatar? Nadie. Tú eres nuestro buen pastor y confiamos en ti. Gracias por los siervos que tú has levantado para cargarnos tiernamente, para enseñarnos, para guiarnos. Concédeles gran gozo y satisfacción. Te lo pedimos por los méritos de Jesús. Amén.
Thank you. Y el pastor Francisco, muy obediente, yo le dije, usted va a orar, lo que no ha llegado el momento, pero quisiera que le diéramos un saludo a este siervo de Dios. Recientemente terminó de traducir la Biblia completa, con la ayuda de su esposa, Alegría, a una versión llamada versión latinoamericana. So he recently finished translating the Bible into a new version, Latin American version. He's a scholar, and with the help of his wife, Joyce, the one who has just prayed, he has done a very wonderful work, and this Bible is now being distributed, and we want to just recognize this great man of God who is with us today. Ya puede sentarse, pastor. Puede sentarse, usted lo invito otra vez. While they figure out what to do with the audio, I'm just going to tell you something. Sometimes I just ask myself why many of the things we have so far were not just allowed while Jesus was walking on this earth. And I realized that Jesus didn't want to have all these complications, right? So he precisely decided just to communicate one-to-one the gospel. And then he went everywhere. We are just so accustomed to stay home and then taking advantage of technology, which is not bad if it is well used. But sometimes we have these setbacks. Well, anyhow, we're going to praise the Lord with music or without music, because God has given to us instruments which are really very interesting. And with the strings of our throat, we are going to praise the Lord. So we're going to wait one more second, but nothing is going to stop us from doing what we've got to do today for the glory of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. So I keep on talking. I keep on teaching, all right? I stop talking. I have to talk back again. Well, you know, I'm just trying just to make this happen. But let me tell you something. And we just take advantage of the situations we have. Give me one more second before you let it go. Let me tell you something. We have to learn from experiences, right? And nowadays, many persons are not attending church. And they have stayed home. And they are not enjoying this fellowship that we're having this morning, because they have clung to technology. But technology fails, but Jesus never fails. Amen?
Thank you.
Okay, despite the fact that we standing here trying to fulfill the ministry that we have and the task that we have, we shake a lot. And despite we do all this, perhaps you don't know how much we shake when we are standing here, because we know the responsibility. But now this is time for me to stop shaking, because I'm going to give this place to the other one who is going to shake at this very moment, who is the invitee, Pastor Omar. I'm just asking him to step forward. Por favor, Pastor, yo les decía en inglés que uno tiembla mucho cuando está acá, pero yo es mi momento de parar, de temblar, para que tiemble él, que es el que va a predicar. Porque él es el pastor invitado, and he is the pastor who started the church. Well, he started with the group. Is the founding pastor of the church. Let's just call it that way. And Pastor Jason is saying that he is the pastor of the church. I mean, the founder of the church. And then I'm going to... Okay, he meant something. He said, you just give me a signal, I'm growing old. And this is that, not that he just did that word. It is time for children to step out for their service. Thank you, Pastor. Thank you, my sister. I'm telling you, don't grow old. I'm telling my people, I'm becoming old. They want to hold me, but I'm just about to to be released, right? Entonces tenemos aquí al Pastor Omar Alfaro, fundador de la iglesia. Lamentamos que no esté la hermana Betty Alfaro, que es su tía. En casa de Betty Alfaro comenzó la iglesia bautista de Leyland con hermanos que están aquí hoy. Pero es una celebración que tenemos pendiente para cuando ella salga del hospital, mantengan en oración, Dios está haciendo la obra. Y sin más, quiero darle el micrófono. I want to just give the microphone to Pastor Omar so he can express himself. And Leo is going to translate because I'm on vacation today on the Pastor's Day.
Gracias.
Thank you, Pastor. Okay, well, while he gets ready, this is the most important thing to do, right? To translate real time, so do not attempt this at home. Only let a professional do it.
Y como decía el hermano Mario, pues
Pastor Mario said,
comenzamos la obra acá y luego nos votaron porque llegaron ellos.
Yeah. So we started the church at Betty's house and then he got kicked out because Pastor Mario came in.
No es cierto. No fue un privilegio, una bendición compartir ese tiempo juntos.
It was a privilege and a blessing to share all those times together.
El Señor nos llamó a hacerlo.
The Lord called us to do it.
Y nosotros solamente teníamos que hacer lo que Dios dijo.
And all we have to do is do what the Lord wants us to do.
Y hoy me gozo de estar acá.
I'm terribly excited to be here.
Con una iglesia que ha crecido.
With a church that has grown.
Y ha crecido para la gloria de Dios.
And has grown to for the praise of to praise the Lord.
Glory to God. Yo soy parte del equipo de los llorones.
Okay, so me too. Pastor Omar cries a lot. Yeah, and so do I. Yeah.
You know. Tú no.
I do. Yeah, yo sí. Yo sí.
Okay. Entonces, vamos a la palabra de Dios.
So we're going to go to the Word of God.
Y vamos a ver lo que Dios tiene para nosotros hoy.
Let's see what God has for us today.
Un pastor invitó a un amigo que encontró en la calle.
A pastor invited a friend who he just found, met in the street.
Y le dijo, te invito a la iglesia.
And told him, I'm inviting you to church.
Y el amigo dijo, ¿y por qué crees que debo ir a la iglesia?
And the friend asked, why do you think I should go to church?
Necesitas conocer a Dios.
You need to meet the Lord. You need to know the Lord.
¿Y qué hacen ustedes en la iglesia? Preguntó el hombre.
And what do you guys do at church?
Nosotros hablamos de las cosas que Dios hace.
We talk about the things that God does.
Entonces yo mejor creo que no voy a ir.
Then I better not go.
¿Por qué?
Why?
Porque si allí ustedes hablan de todo lo que Dios hace, ¿qué no hablarán de mí después de lo que yo hago?
Because if all you do is talk about what God does, what would you say about me when I'm gone?
Vamos entonces a la Biblia y les invito a buscar un texto que muchos sabemos de memoria, Isaías 41:10.
Let's go to the Word of God and Isaiah 41:10.
Dice la Biblia, no temas.
The Bible says, do not be afraid.
Porque yo estoy contigo.
Because I'm with you.
No desmayes.
Do not fear.
porque yo soy tu Dios que te esfuerzo.
Because I'm the Lord who gives you strength.
Siempre te ayudaré.
I will always help you.
Siempre te sustentaré.
I will always sustain you.
Con la diestra de mi justicia.
With the hand of my justice. There you go. I have a helper right there.
Oramos.
Let's pray.
Padre, gracias por esta oportunidad. Gracias por estar juntos. Gracias porque tu palabra está en medio de nosotros y podemos compartirla libremente. Gracias por esta oportunidad. Te pedimos, Dios, que seas tú quien hable a nuestra mente, a nuestro corazón, y que nosotros estemos dispuestos a abrirlo para entender lo que tú tienes para nosotros hoy. En el nombre de Jesús. Amén. Hay cuatro cosas que podemos ver que hallamos en las manos de Dios.
There are four things that we find in God's hands.
Cuando estamos en las manos de Dios,
when we are in God's hands,
estamos en el mejor lugar que podemos estar.
We're in the best possible place we could be.
Y quiero hablar de esas cuatro cosas.
And I'm going to talk to you about those four things
que nosotros podemos experimentar,
that you all can, we all can experience,
cuando estamos en las manos de Dios.
When we are in God's hands.
Dice este texto, no temas porque yo estoy contigo.
The Bible says, do not fear because I'm with you.
Dios es un Dios trascendente.
God is a transcendent God.
Eso significa,
that means,
que Dios está por encima de todo y de todos.
That means that God is above everything and all.
Dios es el creador.
God is the creator.
Y creó todo lo que nosotros hoy podemos ver.
And created everything we see.
No solo en la tierra,
not only on earth,
sino en todo el espacio, en todo el universo.
But also in the entire universe.
Hace unos días mi mente volaba.
A few days ago I was thinking.
Y yo pensaba, qué oportunidad tan linda Dios nos ha dado de conocer todo lo que Él ha creado.
I was thinking about such a great opportunity that God gave us to, que Dios nos dio para qué?
De todo lo que Dios ha creado, lo
para, so we could see all that God has created.
Digo esto porque los profetas y los escritores de la Biblia,
I say this because the prophets and the scribes of the Bible,
no tuvieron la oportunidad que tenemos nosotros de conocer todo este universo.
They didn't have the opportunity we had to see all the His created, which is the universe.
Hoy podemos ver fotos tomadas desde el espacio de lo que es la Tierra.
Today we can see pictures from Earth, allegedly. From space, yeah.
Podemos ver videos.
We can see videos from space.
Y podemos analizar todo lo que Dios creó.
And we can analyze everything that God has created.
Me imagino si ellos hubiesen tenido la oportunidad de conocer eso.
I can imagine if they had had the opportunity to see all that.
Pero nosotros sí la tenemos.
But we have it.
Y entendemos cuán grande es Dios.
And we do understand how great God is.
Ahora, ese Dios que es tan grande.
Now that the God that is so large and so big and so great.
También es un Dios que se hace un Dios personal.
It's also a God that makes himself personal.
Eso se llama la inmanencia de Dios.
That is called the immanent of God.
Dios,
that's immanent, immanent, yes. Right?
O sea, que Dios, yeah, es inmanente. Y Dios te conoce a ti y Dios me conoce a mí.
And God knows you and knows me.
Y conoce todo de cada uno de nosotros.
And he knows everything about us, everything.
Y cuando pienso en ese Dios que es tan grande, pero que a la vez está dentro de nosotros.
And when I think about that God that is so great, so large, but he's also inside of us.
Puedo entender.
I can understand.
Por qué Dios me dice.
Why God says.
No temas, porque yo estoy contigo.
I can understand why God says to me, do not fear because I'm with you.
Un padre tuvo esta experiencia.
A father had this experience.
Tenía dos niñas pequeñas.
He had two little girls.
Y cuando una venía donde él estaba,
and when one of them was coming, approaching him,
ella quería que el padre la lanzara hacia arriba.
He wanted the dad to pick her up and throw her up.
Cuando la otra veía a su hermana hacer esto,
when the other one saw her sister doing that with her dad,
ella también quería que el padre lo hiciera.
She also wanted her dad to do it.
Pero había una diferencia en las dos.
There was a difference between the two girls.
La primera disfrutaba aquello.
The first one enjoyed it thoroughly.
Pero la segunda se asustaba.
But the second one was fearful.
Y el padre se preguntó a sí mismo por qué.
And he was asking himself, you know, why is one enjoying it, why is the other one not enjoying it? I'm fearful.
Se dio cuenta de lo que estaba sucediendo.
Then he realized what was happening.
La primera,
the first one,
se enfocaba en la capacidad del Padre de tomarla en sus brazos cuando ella venía.
The first one only focused on the Father catching her.
La otra se enfocaba en que no podía controlar el vuelo.
On the fact that she could not control the flight, her flight.
Y eso era lo que le hacía temer.
And that's what she feared.
Cada uno de nosotros,
each and every one of us,
todos los días,
every day,
cada mañana,
every morning,
cuando tú te despiertas,
when you wake up,
tú eres lanzado,
we are thrown,
a nuevas experiencias.
To new experiences. Every morning we're thrown to new experiences.
Cada día somos lanzados a cosas que no hemos vivido.
Every morning, every day we're thrown into things that we haven't lived or experienced.
Y hay muchas cosas que nos hacen sentir temor.
And there are many things that make us feel fearful.
Muchas veces tenemos temor.
Many times we're fearful.
A no saber cómo manejar ciertas circunstancias de nuestra
vida. Of not knowing how to handle certain circumstances.
Cómo manejar una mala noticia.
How to handle bad news.
Cómo manejar que me quedo sin empleo.
How to handle the fact that I may lose my job.
Cómo manejar nuestros problemas familiares.
How to deal with family problems.
Y como pastores.
And like, as pastors,
tememos de cómo poder llevar la grey, la iglesia, por donde Dios quiere.
We fear on how to handle that for the church or help the church and the church handle those situations.
La cosa es que nos pasa lo mismo.
The thing is that we as pastors experience the same thing.
Que le pasaba a aquellas niñas.
That those two girls were experiencing.
Tenemos que aprender.
We have to learn.
A enfocarnos.
To focus.
En la capacidad de Dios.
In God's ability.
De sostenernos.
To hold us.
No importa lo alto que vueles.
No matter how high he throws us.
No importa la experiencia que vivas cada
doesn't
día.
Doesn't matter what experience you are going through right now.
Dios tiene la capacidad de tomarte en sus manos.
God has the capacity to pick you up and hold you in his hands.
Y esas manos infunden valor.
And those hands infuse, those hands give you strength and courage.
Por eso Dios dice, no temas porque yo estoy contigo.
That's why God says, do not fear because I'm with you.
Lo segundo que encontramos en las manos de Dios,
the second thing we find in God's hands,
es ánimo.
It's what?
Ánimo.
Encouragement.
Dios dice, no desmayes.
Do not fear.
Porque yo soy tu Dios.
Because I'm your God.
Yo soy tu Dios que te esfuerzo.
I'm your God that gives you strength and
me pregunto, courage. Hablando sobre pastores,
so I wonder, when I'm talking about pastors,
¿cuáles son las cosas que hacen a un pastor desmayar?
What are the things that make pastors feel fearful?
Y va más allá. ¿Cuáles son las cosas que también hacen a un cristiano desmayar?
And also what make Christians feel fearful.
And dismay.
Okay.
O sea, a veces nos hace desmayar el ver que una oración no es contestada por mucho tiempo.
Sometimes we get dismayed, we get worried because we don't see an answer to prayer.
Usted ora por algo y ora y ora y no ve la respuesta.
You pray and pray and pray and you do not see an answer from God.
Y llega el momento en que nos desanimamos.
And there comes a time in which we just lose all courage or encouragement.
Entramos en un conflicto.
We enter into a conflict.
Y pensamos, ¿será que no es la voluntad de Dios?
And then we start thinking that whether maybe that wasn't God's will.
¿Por qué las cosas no funcionan?
How come God, things are not working? How I'm praying about it?
¿Por qué esta oración no es contestada?
Why is this prayer not being answered?
Pero la Biblia dice claramente que debemos orar sin cesar.
But the Bible says that we should pray without ceasing.
A veces también hay algo que nos hace desmayar.
Sometimes something makes us dismayed.
Y es cuando vemos una situación que parece que no va a cambiar.
When we see a situation that we just do not see how it could possibly change.
Esa suegra que no se acaba de ir de la casa.
That mother-in-law that mother-in-law that doesn't leave the house.
No voy a hablar de eso.
Okay, that's my mother-in-law.
La suegra de Leo está aquí.
I had to translate literally.
No quiero problemas con Yaya, ¿verdad? Pero hay situaciones que parecen que no van a cambiar.
But there are situations that just do not seem like they will ever change.
Y cuando tú no ves una salida,
and when you don't see
eso a veces te hace desmayar.
That really makes you dismayed. That really makes you worry.
A veces nos hace desmayar el precio del liderazgo.
Sometimes we're dismayed by the price of leadership, the cost of leadership.
El liderazgo tiene un precio.
There is a cost, there is a price to leadership.
A veces hemos tenido que hablar con líderes.
Sometimes we talk to leaders
que vienen y se quejan.
Who come to us and complain.
Pastor, yo preparo actividades.
Pastor, I prepare and I prepare and plan activities.
Tengo muchos planes.
We have so many plans. I have so many plans.
Pero cuando creo que van a funcionar,
and when I think everything is going to work out fine,
muchos cristianos no colaboran.
Too many Christians do not cooperate. People, membership does not cooperate.
No encuentro apoyo.
I don't find any support.
Y yo les digo,
and I tell them,
bienvenidos al liderazgo.
Yeah, welcome to leadership.
Porque eso es parte del liderazgo.
Because that's part of leadership.
Hay muchas cosas con las que tenemos que luchar.
There are many things that we struggle with or wrestle with.
Que a veces nos hacen desmayar.
That sometimes, you know, makes us feel dismayed. I gotta find a better word for that.
Y eso es algo que el diablo usa mucho en la iglesia.
And that's something that the devil, the enemy, uses a lot at church.
En Números capítulo 21.
In Numbers chapter 21.
El pueblo de Dios había obtenido una victoria.
The people, God's people, had exactly gained a victory, have reached victory.
They had
they
a victory.
Won. They won.
Over some kings. Yeah.
People's God won.
Aquí voy a terminar yo hablando inglés y el español tú. Y después de una victoria grande,
and after a great victory,
dice la palabra que el pueblo tuvo que bordear la tierra de Edom.
It says the word that the people of God had to go around the land of Edom.
Y dice la Biblia
and
que el pueblo se desanimó por el camino.
And the Bible says that people felt fainted as they were going there.
Eso desencadenó o trajo como consecuencia.
That brought us as a consequence.
Que el pueblo comenzó a murmurar.
The people began murmuring, talking, gossiping.
Contra Dios y contra Moisés.
Against God and against Moses.
Y fue cuando Dios trajo la plaga de las serpientes.
And that's when God brought the serpents' plague.
Que mataron a muchas personas en el pueblo.
Who killed many, many people.
Y Dios tuvo que hacer algo ese día.
And God had to do something that day.
¿Qué fue lo que provocó aquella situación?
What was it that brought the situation up?
Que el pueblo se desanimó.
Because people were dismayed, discouraged. People were discouraged.
Y eso trajo los problemas.
And that's what brought all the problems.
Cuando tú y yo nos desanimamos,
when you and I feel discouraged,
el diablo usa eso para quitarte la bendición.
The devil uses that to steal our blessings.
Cuando un pastor se desanima,
when a pastor feels dismayed,
eso daña la
discouraged,
iglesia.
Okay, I got it.
Eso daña la iglesia.
I'm sorry. So when
cuando un pastor se desanima,
yeah, when a pastor feels dismayed,
se desanima la iglesia.
The entire church loses, yeah,
y el trabajo se detiene.
Yeah, I got it. I got it. And right. the work of God stops.
La buena noticia, yeah. La buena noticia está en la Biblia.
It's in the Bible.
En Isaías 40.
In Isaiah 40.
28 al 30. Al 31.
28 to 31.
Allí Dios dice,
God says,
claramente que Él le da esfuerzos al que se cansa.
That God gives strength to the ones who are tired.
Y multiplica las fuerzas al que no tiene.
And multiplies your strength.
Y Dios es el Dios grande, Jehová.
And God is the great Lord, the Jehovah.
Y los que esperan en Jehová.
And who wait on the Lord.
O sea, los que confían en Jehová.
Who trust in the Lord.
Tendrán nuevas fuerzas.
They will have new strength.
Levantarán alas como
they
las
will,
águilas.
They will raise wings like an eagle.
Y correrán y no se cansarán.
They will what?
Correrán.
They will run and they will not get tired.
All right. Y entonces, cuando tenemos la buena noticia en la palabra de Dios,
so when we have the good news in the word of God,
tenemos que aprender,
we have to learn,
que aunque hayan situaciones que nos traten de hacer desmayar,
that even though situations make us feel discouraged,
Dios está con nosotros.
God is with us.
Y nos dice, no desmayes,
and he
porque
says,
yo
do
soy
not dismay,
tu Dios que te fuerza.
Because I'm your Lord that gives you strength.
En las manos de Dios,
in God's hands,
también encontramos confianza.
We also find confidence.
Dice nuestro texto, siempre te ayudaré.
I will always help you, says the word.
Dicen los estudiosos de la Biblia,
yeah, the Bible scholars say,
que la Biblia tiene alrededor,
that the Bible has
Around 3,573 promesas.
Around 3,573 promises.
Yes. Y el apóstol Pablo dice en 2 Corintios.
And Apostle Paul says in 2 Corinthians.
Que todas las promesas de Dios.
That all of God's promises.
Son en el sí.
Son en el.
En el sí y en el amén.
Okay. So every promise is in the Bible are in Him. They are yes and amen.
Yes. O sea que las promesas de Dios son fieles y verdaderas.
Which
en otras palabras.
God's promises are faithful, loyal. God is loyal and He's faithful.
Y cuando Dios dice siempre te ayudaré.
And when God says I will always help you.
Eso da confianza.
That gives you confidence.
Y esto está muy conectado.
And this is all connected.
De alguna manera.
Somehow.
Con Romanos 8:28.
With Romans 8:28.
Donde dice la Biblia.
Where the Bible says.
Que a los que aman a Dios.
For those who love the Lord.
Todas las cosas
les
ayudan
works
a bien.
Out for the best.
¿Cuál es el problema de nosotros los cristianos?
What's our problem?
Que a veces lo olvidamos.
That we sometimes we forget that.
Mire, a veces nos enfermamos de la enfermedad del sí, pero.
Yeah, sometimes we suffer from yes, but.
Y el sí, pero.
And that yes, but.
Significa que cuando usted.
Means that when you.
Comienza a hablar de algo.
Start to talk about something.
Y usted dice,
and you say,
esta fruta,
this fruit,
es hermosa,
is beautiful,
se ve agradable,
it looks pleasant,
tiene un color bonito,
it has a beautiful color,
parece estar dulce,
appears to be sweet,
no me costó muy cara,
it didn't cost me that much.
Y comienza a decir todo lo bueno que tiene esa fruta.
And you start saying all the great things about that particular fruit.
Y por más cosas que usted pone.
And even for all the even though you add so many things to it about the
acerca
fruit,
de la fruta.
All the good things you say about the fruit.
Al final usted dice, pero.
At the end you say, but.
A mí no me gusta.
I don't like it.
¿De qué valió todo lo primero?
So what was it worth it when you were talking about the fruit, how wonderful it is, and all that? If you're going to say yes, but.
¿De qué estoy hablando?
What am I talking about?
Que conocemos la Biblia,
we know the Bible, we know
conocemos
the truth,
las promesas de Dios,
we know the promises,
sabemos que son fieles,
we know that God's loyal and
que
faithful,
todas las cosas nos ayudan a bien,
that all things work out for the best.
Pero cuando estamos en una situación difícil,
but when we're in a bad situation,
y te dicen, Dios puede ayudarte y Dios te da confianza.
And God says God can help you and He can give you confidence and strength.
Dios ha dicho, siempre te ayudaré.
God has said, I will always help you.
Y aunque lo queremos creer,
and even though we want to believe it,
ponemos un pero.
We always add a but to it.
Muchas veces los pastores escuchamos,
many times our pastors hear,
cuando damos consejería,
when we counsel somebody,
y le hablamos a la gente de confiar en Dios,
and we talk to people about trusting the Lord,
muchos dicen, sí, pastor, pero.
Many of us say, yes, pastor, but.
Y allí vienen todas las excusas.
And that's when all the excuses come out.
Es que usted no sabe lo que estoy pasando.
You don't know what I'm going through.
Y hacen que el problema sea tan grande.
And they make the problem so huge and big. And,
que Dios se queda tan pequeñito.
And they make God look small.
Y aunque creemos todo lo que dice la Biblia.
And even though we believe everything the Bible says.
Echamos las promesas de Dios por tierra.
We always discard the promises of God.
Y Dios dice, siempre.
And God says, always.
Siempre.
Always.
Siempre.
Always.
Aún en las situaciones que no entiendes.
Even in the most difficult situations that you do not understand.
Aún en las que no te gustan.
Even in the situations that you just don't like.
Ahí yo te ayudaré.
I will help you there. That's
Porque
where
Dios
I will help you.
Todo lo torna para bien.
Because God turns everything to good, to goodness, to.
Finalmente.
Finally.
En las manos de Dios.
In God's hands.
Encontramos.
We find
seguridad.
Security.
Termina nuestro texto diciendo.
Our text ends up saying.
Siempre te sustentaré.
I will always sustain you.
Con la diestra de mi justicia.
With the righteousness of my hands.
Right. Thank you. Cuando usted ve un niño pequeño.
When you see a little kid.
Y un niño comienza a caminar.
And the kid starts walking.
O cuando un niño comienza a montar bicicleta.
When they start riding a bike.
Y usted ve al padre de ese niño al lado del niño.
And you see his father.
El padre siempre va a estar cerca.
The dad will always be near him.
Y ahí estamos pendientes de ese niño.
Always trying to catch that
para
fall.
Que no tropiece, para que no caiga.
Make sure that he doesn't tumble or fall or hurt himself.
Y ese día que quitamos las rueditas de los lados de la bicicleta.
And when we take the training wheels out. off of the
ahí vamos con la mano cerca del asiento.
We're always holding onto that seat.
Y corremos al lado
and
del niño.
We run behind that bike.
Y nos cansamos los viejos.
We get tired, but because he's old.
Pero ahí vamos. Él se cansa.
Okay,
pero,
I'm old.
Pero estamos pendientes de que el niño no caiga.
But we're really watching to make sure the kid doesn't fall off.
Desde que nosotros comenzamos en nuestra vida cristiana,
ever since we start with our Christian walk,
desde el día en que decidimos seguir a Cristo,
from the moment we decide to start following Christ,
y los pastores desde el día que elegimos seguir a Cristo,
and pastors the day we decide to start following Christ,
y elegimos hacerle caso a Dios,
and we choose to obey God,
en todo lo que Él quiere,
in everything He wants,
podemos confiar,
we can trust,
de que la mano de Dios,
that God's hand,
la mano derecha de Dios, su diestra,
God's right hand,
está ahí para sostenernos y para sustentarnos.
It's right there to hold us and sustain us.
No importa que vayas a caer.
It doesn't matter if you're going to fall.
No importa que vengan situaciones que sean difíciles.
It doesn't matter if you're facing situations that are difficult.
No importa que vengan cosas que nunca has vivido.
No importa that you start facing things that you have never faced before as a pastor.
Dios ha dicho.
God has said.
Siempre te sustentaré.
I will always sustain you.
Con la diestra de mi justicia.
With the right hand, with my right hand.
En las manos de Dios.
In God's hands.
Encontramos valor.
We find courage.
En las situaciones que nos infunden temor.
In the situations that
en las manos
fear,
de Dios
in God's hands,
encontramos seguridad.
We find security.
En las manos de Dios
in God's hands,
encontramos ánimo.
¿Encontramos what?
Ánimo.
Oh, yeah, courage. We find courage and courage.
Y en las manos de Dios encontramos confianza.
And in God's hands we find confidence.
Cuatro cosas.
Four things
que nunca nos deben faltar.
That will never, we should never lack.
Tanto a las creyentes en Cristo.
The membership, the Christians,
como a cada pastor,
as for each and every pastor,
que podamos saber que estamos seguros,
that we're sure,
en las manos de Dios,
in God's hands.
Que Dios les bendiga.
May God bless you.
Jesús ha dado la orden, firmes y adelante.
Jesus has given the command, let's march forward.
Él está a las puertas y quiere hallarnos fiel.
And he wants to find us faithful.
Puestos en pie cantamos, firmes y adelante.
To,
firmes y adelante.
Together, let's march forward.
Mostrémosle al Señor que así estamos.
And let's show the Lord that we feel like
en el puesto que nos quiere para obtener la victoria en Él.
Fuerte abre Good morning, everyone. Buenos días a todos, hermanos. I would like to begin by saying that I consider it an honor to stand here today and speak to recognize the contributions made over the years by so many pastors gathered here today. Me gustaría comenzar diciendo que es un honor para mí estar parada en esta mañana para reconocer las contribuciones hechas por muchos años por estos pastores aquí reunidos. Can you please stand? All the pastors here today, can you please stand? Thank you. It's not changing. Okay. Thank you, Pastor. Your messages are full of insight and truth. Thank you for continuing to preach the whole counsel of God. Gracias, pastores. Sus mensajes están llenos de verdad y de sabiduría. Gracias por continuar predicando todo el consejo de Dios. Thank you. You may sit. If you consult the dictionary, you will see that pastors, priests, is often defined as an intermediary between the people and God. We, as a congregation, a Iglesia Bautista de Lakeland, IBL, do not need a dictionary to tell us the meaning of pastor's role. Since our pastor, Mario Rodriguez, he wonderfully defined the word with his life. Si consultan el diccionario, pueden ver que la palabra pastor es muy frecuente definida como un intermediario entre Dios y las personas. Nosotros como congregación en Iglesia Bautista de Lakeland no necesitamos el diccionario para definir la palabra pastor, porque nuestro pastor Mario Rodriguez, a él no le gustan mucho los reconocimientos, pero hoy es su día. He doesn't like too much recognition, but today is his day and your day. So no necesitamos el diccionario, ¿verdad? Porque nuestro pastor Mario Rodriguez, él define la palabra con su vida. In addition to enjoying your sermons from the pulpit, we appreciate the sermon that you live out right before our eyes. Your example serves to inspire us to live our lives before our fellow men in a manner that would please God. En adición a disfrutar sus sermones desde el púlpito, nosotros apreciamos el sermón que él vive día a día con su vida delante de nuestros ojos. Su ejemplo sirve de inspiración para nosotros, de manera que podamos vivir nuestra vida frente a nuestros hermanos de una manera que pueda agradar a Dios. We also deeply appreciate the special things you do during the year, from visiting hospitals and nursing homes and conducting weddings and funerals if necessary, to preparing and preaching messages. And of course, we remain profoundly affected by the little things you do, like bending down to eye level to make time for our children. And the prayers you breathe to heaven in the privacy of your room and those wonderful and full of wisdom messages you send each morning in our chats. Nosotros apreciamos profundamente todas esas cosas especiales que usted hace durante el año, desde visitar a los hospitales, los nursing homes y conducir bodas y funerales si fuera necesario, hasta preparar sus sermones. Lo disfrutamos todos. Y por supuesto, estamos profundamente afectados por esas pequeñas cosas que usted hace, como agacharse para estar al contacto de los ojos de nuestros niños. También por esas oraciones que usted eleva al cielo en la privacidad de su hogar. Y esos maravillosos, llenos de sabiduría, mensajes que nos manda todas las mañanas en nuestros chats. Todos los esperamos con mucha ansia. I'm pretty sure if we have more people from the different congregations, we have pastors here today, stand up here and speak about the pastors, they all would agree that pastors are awesome. But before we proceed to present and honor all of them with their beautiful, suitable helpers, I would like to invite you to reflect in this short video. Let us watch. Estoy segura que si tuviéramos aquí personas, hermanos de otras diferentes congregaciones donde tenemos pastores invitados esta mañana, si se pararan aquí a hablar de sus pastores, estoy segura que todos llegaríamos al consenso de que los pastores son grandiosos. Pero antes que yo comience a llamarlos delante para presentarlo con sus hermosas esposas y ayudas idóneas, quiero invitarlos a reflexionar en este pequeño video. Vamos a verlos.
Morning, beloved. You may have a seat if you can. This is the day the Lord has made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. This morning, I'd like to share a very familiar story with you. A few years back, a young lady went off to college.
Great. Here we go again with that story about the elephant. I mean, don't you have another story to prove your point? I've heard it like 3 times this year already. And you know what? It's not even that funny. Yeah, I said it. Not even funny. Maybe I should fill out one of those comment cards. It's not like I'm asking all that much. I come here every Sunday or so for some coffee, fellowship, and to hear a new message. The least you can do is make it fresh and insightful and funny and moving and theologically sound and historically accurate every week. Maybe I am asking too much. Probably way too much. I mean, Pastor did visit Joe in the hospital and celebrated with us when Michelle was born and was there when Susan lost her mom and encouraged me to fight for my family when we were on the brink of separation. Now that I think about it, Pastor's been like a counselor, a mentor, and a friend when I needed it the most. Pastors are awesome. Go ahead, Pastor. Tell that story again. I'll even laugh this time.
Amen. Pastors are awesome. Los pastores son grandiosos, ¿verdad? Amen. Let's go back to the PowerPoint, please. Thank you. Jeremías 3:15 nos dice, y os daré pastores según mi corazón, que os apacienten con ciencia y con inteligencia. Jeremiah 3:15. Then I will give you shepherds after my own heart, who will lead you with knowledge and understanding. I'm sorry, I'm so bad with this. Thank you, Pastor Jason and Revive Church, for making IBL feel so welcome here. Queremos tomar... Queremos tomar este momento para darle las gracias al Pastor Jason. I'm sorry, I don't know how to pronounce your last name. Seeger. Queremos agradecer al Pastor Jason Seeger y su congregación de Revive Church porque nos han hecho sentir muy bienvenidos aquí. Dice Hebreos 13:7. Acordaos de vuestros pastores que os hablaron la palabra de Dios. Considerad cuál haya sido el resultado de su conducta e imitad su fe. Hebrews 13:7. Remember your leaders who spoke the word of God to you. Consider the outcome of their faith. I'm sorry. Consider the outcome of their way of life and imitate their faith. Genesis 2:18. Génesis 2:18. Y dijo Jehová Dios, no es bueno que el hombre esté solo, le daré ayuda idónea para él. And the Lord God said, it is not good for the man to be alone, I will make a helper suitable for him. I want to take a moment to ask all the pastor's wives here today to please stand up. We want to thank you for consistently supporting your husband spiritually, emotionally, and physically. Queremos tomarnos un pastor, un momento, perdón, para pedirles a las esposas que se pongan de pies y agradecerle por constantemente estar apoyando a sus esposos espiritualmente, emocionalmente y físicamente. For smiling when your own heart is breaking. Thank you. That takes grace. Por sonreír cuando tu propio corazón se quiere desmoronar. Gracias. For all your sacrifices, both visible and invisible. Thank you. God sees them all. Por todos sus sacrificios, los visibles y los invisibles. Gracias. Dios los ve todos. For being authentic, for not trying to be superwoman. Thank you. People can always relate to real. Por ser auténtica, por no tratar de ser una heroína. Gracias. Las personas siempre pueden confiar en lo real, en lo auténtico. Thank you so much. You may say. Thank you. Queridos pastores aquí presentes, gracias por las mañanas de domingo y las noches de miércoles. Gracias por las semillas plantadas y los discípulos a los que nutren. Gracias por cada predicación y las oraciones que elevan. Gracias por el sabio consejo y las palabras de aliento. Gracias por su sacrificio y servicio. Dear pastors, thank you for the early Sunday morning and the late Wednesday night. Thank you for the seeds you plant and disciples you nurture. Thank you for the sermons you preach and the prayers you lift up. Thank you for the wise counsel and the words of encouragement. Thank you for the sacrifice and service. Salmos 23:6 nos dice, ciertamente el bien y la misericordia me seguirán todos los días de mi vida, y en la casa de Jehová moraré por largos días. Psalm 23:6. Surely your goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Cuán hermosos son sobre los montes los pies del que trae alegres nuevas, del que anuncia la paz, del que trae nuevas del bien, del que publica salvación, del que dice a Sion, tu Dios reina. Isaiah 52:7. How beautiful on the mountains are the feet of those who bring good news, who proclaim peace, who bring good tidings, who proclaim salvation, who say to Zion, your God reigns. Amen. Es nuestra oración en esta mañana para todos ustedes, pastores. It's our prayer for you today. Números 6:24-26. Jehová te bendiga y te guarde. Jehová haga resplandecer su rostro sobre ti y tenga de ti misericordia. Jehová alce sobre ti su rostro y ponga en ti paz. Numbers 6:24-26. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face towards you and give you peace. Amen. Quisiera ahora dar una palabra de aliento a sus corazones. And I would like to give you a word of encouragement. Hebreos 6:10 dice, porque Dios no es injusto para olvidar vuestra obra y el trabajo de amor que habéis mostrado hacia su nombre, habiendo servido a los santos y sirviéndoles aún. Hebrews 6:10, God is not unjust. He will not forget your work and the love you have shown him as you help his people and continue to help them. Ahora les recuerdo una bella promesa de Dios. Now we'd like to remind you of this beautiful promise. Jeremías 29:11. Porque yo sé los pensamientos que tengo acerca de vosotros, dice Jehová, pensamientos de paz y no de mal, para daros el fin que esperáis. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future. What a beautiful assurance. Los apreciamos, pastores. No hemos parado de dar gracias por ustedes, recordándolos en nuestras oraciones. We appreciate you, pastors. Ephesians 1:16. I have not stopped giving thanks for you. Remember you in my prayers. Amen. And now I'm going to be presenting all these men of courage to you. Please stand up again and come up front. We are very, very honored that you are with us today. Aplausos, por favor. Gracias a todos los pastores que pudieron acompañarnos en esta mañana. Teníamos mucho más invitados. We have many pastors invited as well, but they couldn't make it for different reasons. Pero estamos muy agradecidos por los que sí pudieron llegar en esta mañana. Y ahora yo me voy a apoyar del pastor Mario y del pastor Jason para que ellos se los presenten. ¿Verdad? Que los conocen mejor que yo. Nuestro querido pastor Mario, este sí se los presento yo. Our dear pastor Mario.
We're going to believe that, right? our dearest Pastor Mario. I'm translating what you said. Let's start honoring gray hair, right? Pastor Francisco Liévano. Pastor Francisco, he's colored. He's been pastor for many, many, many years. He has just blessed, well, I cannot find an appropriate word to say how many persons he has blessed, and he's still blessing so far. As I was telling you, even translating the Bible, I'm working constantly without ceasing until the last moment of his life. Francisco, right? And we just greet him. Para todo Francisco, un hombre de Dios tremendo. Y tenemos otro gran hombre de Dios, Omar. This is a great man of God. He has been planting churches in some other countries as well, and he have always worked without no other interest than serving the Lord and bless everyone, and we appreciate that. There are a lot of things to say about him, but we have no much time, but thank you, Pastor. Así que le agradecemos a Dios por la vida de este hombre, que ha estado incluso en lugares muy difíciles plantando la semilla del Evangelio. And we have here Pastor Seeger, Jason Seeger. He's the best of all pastors. Otherwise, I would be thrown out. I was told to say that, right? Indeed, he's a great pastor. He has a tremendous heart, and his congregation know about that. He has welcomed us here even without knowing us. And he and all of you, because according to how the pastor is, the church is. And you are so good, so nice. I don't find the appropriate words just to recognize whatever you've done for us. But you are in our hearts already. And we appreciate his job and his enthusiasm, all his ideas, always renovating things, thinking of better things. Now he's planning for 100 years. Christ is about to come, but he's planning for 100 years. We are so enthusiastic about that, and we really appreciate it. And now he's going to present the other pastor on his right hand, so you won't get tired of me, right?
We could never get tired of you, Pastor Mario, because you're the second best. No, you're the best. You're the best. I am truly thankful for you and our friendship and the opportunity to have gotten to know your church family and to learn from you and to grow with you. And whether God gives us another 100 years together or whatever his plan is, I'm excited for what God's doing in us and through us and thankful for you. We have not got to meet yet, my friend, but I have a feeling, are you Christine's father? You're with Justin. Okay. Sorry, I probably just made you way older than you are.
It's all right.
Tell us your name.
My name is Minister Lorenzo McCutcheon. I've been a youth pastor for 17 years and getting ready to start my ministry as a pastor.
Wonderful.
Next year, in January.
And so you're down in Fort Meade, is that
Fort
correct?
Fort Meade, yes.
We're thankful for you.
Thank you for being here, for what you do. We appreciate you. And for putting up with me calling you really old there. And this is Pastor Jason Troy, and he's our youth pastor. He has been at this church for probably 20 years. And it has been an amazing thing to see how God has worked in his heart and called him recently into the ministry. And he's working on his ordination right now. And we are very thankful for him and his work.
Bueno, sin muchas más palabras, les queremos agradecer grandemente por estar aquí esta mañana. Without many more words, we just want to say thank you again for being here today. We have little presents for you in the fellowship room later and for your beautiful wives. Thanks a lot. We appreciate you, pastors. Muchísimas gracias. Los apreciamos, pastores.
Okay, you may sit down, and Pastor Jason Seeger is going just to get to the closing time here with his band and a final prayer while we just come forward to worship by means of our offerings. But he's going to lead all this part, so pay close attention to his instruction. And after we are done with this last part, everyone is going to use the side door. We go straight to the fellowship. We're going to have some refreshment. We can have some fellowship as well. Thanks, everyone, for having come today to worship the Lord together.
Leo, are you still on duty? Do you mind translating for just a quick second?
Sure, absolutely.
You may have noticed in the notes.
Ustedes pueden haber visto en las notas.
Pastor Mario said this would be a brief comment of encouragement.
Que el Pastor Mario dijo que iba a ser uno mensaje corto.
My friend knows me better than I thought he did.
Pero mi amigo me conoce mejor de lo que yo pensaba.
A few years ago, I was in Haiti for the first time.
Hace unos años yo estaba en Haití.
And I sat in a worship service where there was no interpreter. It was all in Creole.
Y estuve en una congregación donde en el servicio no había ningún traductor.
And so I watched the faces.
Y lo que hice fue ver las caras de la gente.
And I listened to the songs.
Oí las canciones.
And I listened to the Spirit of God.
Y oí el Espíritu de Dios.
And one of the things that he impressed on me that day.
Y una de las cosas que el Espíritu de Dios me puso en mi corazón.
Is how big.
Es cuán grande.
How diverse.
Cuán diverso.
And how beautiful.
Y cuán hermoso
the body of Christ is.
El cuerpo de Cristo es.
In Revelation, John got a picture
en
of what the church is going to be like.
En Apocalipsis, Juan tiene una foto de lo que.
He wrote this. After this, I looked.
Él escribió esto.
And there before me was a great multitude.
Y ahí mismo enfrente mí hubo una gran multitud.
And no one could count it.
Y nadie lo podía contar.
From every nation.
De cada nación, de todas las naciones.
Tribe.
Tribus,
people,
gente,
and language,
y lenguajes,
and standing before the throne of the Lamb,
y parado enfrente del trono del Cordero,
they were wearing white robes,
estaban vistiendo,
holding palm branches in their hands,
las vestiduras blancas,
and they cried out in one loud voice,
y ellos gritaron en una sola voz,
salvation belongs to our God,
la salvación
who
pertenece
sits on
a Dios,
the throne,
quien se siente en el trono,
and to the Lamb.
Y al Cordero de Dios.
That is an answer to Jesus' prayer.
Eso es una respuesta a la oración a Jesucristo.
In John 17, he looked through the ages
en
and he
17,
saw you.
En Juan 17, él vio a través de las edades, de las eras.
And he saw me.
Y él me vio a mí.
And he prayed that we would be one.
Y él oró de que seríamos, que fuéramos uno.
As he and the Father are one.
Como el Padre somos uno.
My encouragement for us as believers.
Lo que les digo a ustedes como creyentes.
As churches.
Como iglesias,
as the body of Christ,
como el cuerpo de Dios,
is that we don't wait to stand before the throne.
Es que no esperemos hasta estar en el frente del trono de Dios.
Before we act in unity.
Antes de que para actuar en unidad.
Today has been a beautiful prelude.
Hoy ha sido un bello preámbulo.
Of what is to come.
De lo que viene.
One day we will speak one voice.
Un día solamente vamos a hablar en una sola voz.
In one language.
Un lenguaje.
to praise one God.
Para glorificar y honrar a un solo Dios.
Pastor Mario says it's going to be Spanish.
Pastor Mario said el pastor dijo que iba a ser en español.
And since he is older and wiser.
Porque él es mucho más viejo y
I will not dispute him.
No voy a argue with him. Discutir con él.
But I tell you the building blocks of that day.
Pero todas las bases para ese día, la fundación,
are being put together in our lives.
Las estamos poniendo juntas
because
hoy,
of Jesus.
Nuestras vidas. Porque Jesucristo,
because
por Jesucristo,
of Jesus.
Por Jesucristo.
Don't let go of what happened today.
No dejen este sentimiento que tuvimos hoy.
Let's go to the future together.
Vamos al futuro juntos.
And lift up the Waymaker.
Para honrar al Creador del cielo y del universo.
It's in Jesus and Jesus alone that we have the opportunity to be one body.
Solamente en Jesucristo podemos ser un solo cuerpo.
I invite you to join us in singing.
Los invito a cantar conmigo.
And to take advantage of this opportunity to give.
Y aprovechar esta oportunidad para dar.
Eddie, if you would come. Eddie is going to stand by the plate that is for Revive Church.
Okay. Eddie va a estar parado con la ofrenda para la iglesia, con el plato para la iglesia.
And Andrew, would you mind coming? And he'll stand
de
by
la iglesia
the plate
de Revive.
That is for IBL.
Yeah. Eddie es con la iglesia de Revive y Andrés está con la iglesia de IBL.
For those of you that are from Revive Church, this is different for you.
Para todos ustedes que están con la iglesia de Revive, es diferente para ustedes.
We won't be passing the plates today.
No vamos a estar pasando la
You'll come
la bandeja forward. De la ofrenda. Ustedes van a venir.
And if you're shy, it's okay.
Y si ustedes son tímidos,
it's okay. It's this okay. is an opportunity to worship.
Es una oportunidad para que ustedes
and to act out leaving your gift before the altar of God.
Para que ustedes pasen a dar sus regalos a los pies de Dios.
In case I don't get to say it again.
En caso de que no lo pueda decir otra vez.
Thank you, Leo. Good job.
Thank you, me. Good job. Gracias.
Gracias. Let's pray. Almighty God, we are thankful today for the opportunity to gather as one body and to lift up the name of Jesus Christ. We pray that you would not only take the financial offering that we give now, but the offering of our lives, and that you would use it for the glory and honor of the only one who is worthy. That your kingdom would come, that your will would be done, that it would be built on this earth in lives of hearts of people who are changed because of the cross of Christ. You are the one who makes the way. We cling to you. We love you. We worship you in all that we have and all that we are. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Would you stand with us and come forward with your offering and sing with your voices?
My God, that is who you are. You are here, touching every heart. I worship you, I worship you. You are here, healing every heart. I worship you, I worship you. You are here, turning lives around. I worship you, I worship you.
to sing through that part one more time if you would. You're a waymaker, promise keeper.
You are waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God. That is who you are. And that is who you are. That is who you are. That is who you are. And that is who you are.
I love hearing the kids sing that out. That is so cool. So awesome. We've got one more prayer, Pastor. If you would come and close us in prayer.
Oremos.
Let's pray.
Amante Dios y Padre nuestro.
Dear lovely Lord, our Father.
Nos presentamos delante de ti.
We come in front of you.
Con corazones contritos y humillados.
With our hearts contrite and humble.
Alabamos tu santo nombre.
We worship your name.
Te damos gracias por la comunión.
We thank you, Lord, for the communion
de tus hijos.
Of your kid, your children.
Somos de diferentes iglesias.
We're all from different churches.
Pero pertenecemos a una sola iglesia.
But we belong to just one and only church.
Somos solo un cuerpo.
We are all one body.
Cristo es el Señor.
Christ is the Lord.
Él es la esperanza.
He is our hope.
Y nuestro Señor.
And our dear and our Lord.
Alabado sea tu santo nombre.
We praise you, Lord.
Y ahora te rogamos que nos despidas con tu paz y con tu bendición.
Now we ask you, Lord, that you
con tu gracia
with your grace
y con tu salvación
and with your salvation.
En el nombre y por los méritos de Jesucristo nuestro Señor.
In the name of the Lord.
Amén.
Amen.
Amen, amen. Thank you for coming today. Please join us right next door in the fellowship hall for refreshments right after this. And then for those that would like to help set up tonight for Fall Festival, we are meeting at 5 p.m.